Right, hello everybody, welcome along to another interview today. This time I'm joined by conditional jockey to Nicky Richards, Danny McMenamin. Danny, how are you today?
Very, very well, thank you. How are yourself looking?
I'm not doing too bad, not doing too badly. So the first question I wanted to ask you was, what's life like for you during this pandemic at the moment with no jump racing going on?
It's the same as everyone else at the moment, really. Nothing really too much to do, but it's a tight note for the best. Being a bit quiet lately, I have a few weeks off work. I've been out running every day and trying to keep busy.
So in terms of the jump season that's just been, what was your opinions on that for yourself? Was you quite pleased with how it went?
Oh, I was very pleased how it went, yeah. Had a very good season. Ended up 28 winners and leading the Northern Conditionals, so everything went well.
So in terms of being based with Nicky Richards, that's where you're based. What's he like to work for on a day-to-day basis?
He's very, very good to work for. He's easygoing and he likes to have a laugh, so makes everything a bit easier, you know.
So going back to when you first started out, was you always brought up around horses? Was that sort of your background?
None of my family really were into racing, but where I come from, Dunpatrick, it's very racing town. There's local track there and everyone goes out, and Tony Dobbin would be the main man. He came from there and everyone looked up to him, and that's what got me going, really.
So what was your first proper racing memory? Was there a particular race or an event that you remember quite fondly that made you that sticks in the mind quite well?
Probably just going to the local racetrack in my hometown as a kid with my family, and that's where I fell in love with the sport anyway, and that's where I knew then I wanted to be a jockey.
So in terms of your racing idols, you mentioned Tony Dobbin. Was anybody else such as AP McCoy, Ruby Walsh, who at the time were at the peak of their powers? Was there many others who you felt you looked up to?
Yeah, obviously Ruby Walsh, he was a big idol of mine. How can you not admire him, everything he's achieved, and he's a proper role model for young lads coming through.
So in terms of horses you've ridden this season, I was looking online before doing this interview, you've got quite a good strike rate with Nuts Well, 75% strike rate riding the horse. What's he been like to ride throughout the course of the season?
He's been a grand horse for me this season. I rode him for the first time about 2 minutes. I rode him first time about a year ago. He did very well with him, I thought, this season, because when I rode him about a year ago, he just didn't seem like his old self that he produced for him. But this year, look, to be fair to Anne and Ian, they've brought him out fine, firing on all cylinders, and he's been a grand little horse, and he's done great this season.
So in terms of actual horses, was there a horse in particular that you think's been a big part in your career so far, one that's potentially launched your career?
Well, I'd say Nisha winning the Greatwood for Brian Ellison. I'd say that put me on the map and got things rolling.
So also in terms of another horse that you've ridden quite well, Frighten Rabbit, you've got a good strike rate on board, him, 37%. What's the horse been like to ride as well throughout the course of the season?
Yeah, well, he's a funny little lad. He sort of can't touch his mouth. You sort of just leave it up to him. So you go whatever speed he wants to go, whenever sort of you can get a breather in, take it as you can, and he's a very competitive little type. He's hardly ever the first three, so he's nice to be a part of.
In terms of course as well in the north, is there a particular course that you feel like you've got quite a good strike rate around? Is there any favourite courses you like to enjoy riding around?
I say Perth would probably be a nice track, just with the atmosphere in the summertime. It's a bit warmer as well, so it suits us all. And Carlisle is a hard track to get used to, but I'm slowly, surely getting there.
And just finally, Dane, before I let you go, what would your hopes be for next season? I know it's quite a long way off at the moment with things as they are, but would you have any particular hopes or goals to look forward to next season?
Yeah, look, I still have a £3 claim, so might as well just try and go for the conditional title. That would be the main aim. It'll take some doing, mind, with a lot of competitive, talented lads coming through, but look, we'll give it a go and we'll set the bar high and sure, if we achieve it, but if we don't, we can always look to improve.
Danny, that's wonderful. Thanks for joining me. I really appreciate that. Thank you, Danny.
Well, brother. Thank you.
Right, recording there.